allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please keep our servicemen and women in your thoughts and prayers as you go about your daily lives in the hopes that they arrive home safe. Thank you. Welcome to the Senate Standing Committee on Local Governments. We have with us our ranker, Senator Stuart Cousins, as well as Senator Patty Ritchie. Senator, thank you very much for being here. We have voting sheets for whom?
Senator Ball, Senator McDonald, and Senator Klein.
So we do have a quorum. We have a number of items on today, nothing hopefully controversial. But to start, Senator Young is sponsoring Senate Bill 2446, which she has asked that we hold at her request. Good morning.
Sorry, my military son was on the phone, so I take this policy.
I hope he's well.
Oh, he is.
Excellent.
He's in Colorado Springs. It's not a bad duty.
We're just getting started. Senator Young has asked that we hold Senate 2446. So we'll move to Senate 3357, sponsored by Senator LaValle.
Senate 3357 by Senator LaValle, an act to amend the village law in relation to a school member on village board of trustees. This legislation amends the village law to provide that the board of trustees of a village board by resolution or by local law, subject to permissive referendum, may appoint an ex officio student member to such board. Such student member would be a senior in a high school of a school district in which all or part of such school district is contained within such village. The term of this student member shall be for 1 year. It would begin on July 1st preceding the senior year of such student member and the end of following June 30th. A vacancy in such office would be filled by the board for the remainder of such term.
Thank you. Senator Little.
Yeah, I couldn't figure out why a village couldn't do this on its own.
Because
a village can decide to be a village and create a village. It's the only entity, municipal entity, that can create itself.
And by local law, they probably could, for the individual village, may take that option. Because you're not creating any position in law.
Can't vote anyway.
It's more of a ceremonial position, but there also is no harm in allowing, a state position on it as well. It is what it is.
So you're actually amending the village law, but for all villages.
And if they want to, then they would exercise their local option, which they may have already.
Yeah, I would think so. But, okay.
I get a motion to move it. Motion by Senator Ritchie, second by Senator Little. All in favor?
Aye. Women rule here today.
You know?
I have.
As a father of four women and as a husband
to one.
I was outnumbered when it was just my wife and I, so I'm very familiar with that story. The next bill is Senate 4229, sponsored by Senator Marcellino.
This is 4229 by Senator Marcellino, an act to amend the Suffolk County Tax Act in relation to the sale of delinquent tax liens on brownfield properties. This bill would add a new section 46A to the Suffolk County tax law within the unconsolidated laws to authorize Suffolk County to sell or dispose of tax liens for less than the outstanding taxes due on such liens on parcels identified by the county as brownfield. Pursuant to this provision of the bill, any site which has been designated as a Superfund site would be eligible for inclusion. The intent of the legislation is to promote the sale or disposal of these county tax liens so as to satisfy open real property tax liens and promote the return of these parcels to productive real property tax paying use. Home rule has been received on it, and it also passed last year, 61 to 0.
Any questions?
No, it's only for Suffolk County, though, isn't it?
Correct. It's only for Suffolk County. It may be a pilot program that we can consider going forward, but I think it gives the community some flexibility in dealing with some
absolutely.
Of these properties.
And, in other communities as well. Okay.
Can I get a motion to move it?
Move it.
Motion by Senator Little, second by Senator Stuart Cousins. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Bill 240. Next bill, Senate 45146, sponsored by Senator Livis.
Senate 4514 by Senator Libous, an act to amend the real property tax law in relation to the redemption of multiple liens on farm properties. This bill would allow a farmer to redeem their earliest tax lien first, and this helped farmers avoid additional accrued interest and a potential foreclosure process spurred by factors that may largely be out of the farmer's control.
Any questions? Motion to move.
Move.
By Senator Little, second by Senator Stewart Cousins. All in favor?
Aye.
I second.
Bill's reported. The next bill, Senate 5625, has been held at the sponsor's request. Next, we have a bill sponsored by Senator Stewart Cousins, Senate 6460.
Senate 6460 by Senator Stewart Cousins, an act to amend the local finance law in relation to bonds and notes in the city of Yonkers. Specifically, this bill would amend Section 5440, the local finance law, to permit the city of Yonkers to market serial bonds at private sale through June 30th, 2013.
It's an extender.
Right.
Any questions? Need a motion to move? Motion by Senator Ritchie, second by Senator Stewart Cousins. All in favor?
Aye.
I-6, nays one, Senator Ball.
Bill is reported. Next bill is a bill that I sponsored, Senate 6625A.
Senate 6625A by Senator Martin, an act to amend the town law and the village law in relation to the enactment of certain zoning ordinances. This legislation would prohibit the ability of a town or village to enact zoning ordinances that would render the majority of existing residential properties within a zoned area as non-conforming.
Essentially what it does, and sometimes in our communities we have efforts to upzone properties where you have, let's say, predominantly 50 by 100 properties in the village. At one point, when the properties are already 90%+ developed, upzones the entire area to 75 by 100, essentially making everybody in the community non-conforming so that those parcels that are left open are not able to be developed. I've experienced that in the past. Certainly, I've seen it in certain communities. I've seen it in my own community that we had to deal with an effort from 20-plus years ago where they did upzone an entire area, essentially making every property in the area non-conforming for the benefit of very few. So I think that anytime you do that, what you're really doing is disenfranchising those people who have properties that were conforming.
So not grandfathering them in.
They're not grandfathering the open space in. And oftentimes, and it happens in many communities, property owners will buy, a homeowner will buy a piece of property, and then they may buy the parcel next door with the idea someday in the future that they may want to build a house on it, either for a child or sell it as part of their own retirement. By upzoning that way, especially when you already have a master plan with a certain configuration, you're disenfranchising people.
Well, how about the Adirondack Park Agency, who decided that you needed 26% of the Adirondacks, you needed 42 acres to build a house, to have one principal building. And so somebody that owned 100 acres or maybe 80 acres can still only do one house, or somebody has a 100 acre parcel that they thought, was their family's inheritance, can put two principal buildings on it.
Which I think, again, is...
So this is statewide?
This is statewide.
Do you have a sponsor in the assembly?
Not yet.
Oh, we need one.
We'll find that.
It's a good bill.
Can I get a motion to move it? Motion by Senator Ritchie, second by Senator Little. All in favor?
Aye.
I second.
Bill is reported. Next bill is sponsored by Senator Seward, Senate 6811.
Senate 6811 by Senator Seward, an act to amend Chapter 585 of the laws of 2011 relating to authorizing the Village of Ilion to face a litigation settlement by the issuance of serial bonds and or anticipation notes in relation to the requirement of issuing and levying taxes on such bonds and notes. Specifically, this bill amends Chapter 585 of the laws of 2011 to finance a litigation settlement of $1.1 million against the Village by the issuance of serial bonds. Such litigation was between multiple local governments in the county of Herkimer and the county related to the payment of workers' compensation costs. The chapter removed reference to Section 10.10 of the local finance law, as well as extending the time period for the bonding authority to January 31st, 2013.
Any questions? I'll accept the motion. Move it.
I move it.
Motion by Senator Stewart Cousins, second by Senator Little. All in favor?
Aye.
I-6, nays one, Senator Ball.
The next bill?
Yes, he's not doing extensions.
to by Senator Seward as well, 76814, and it's, I believe, a companion to the previous bill, in this case, for the village of Herkimer, correct? Same terms, same conditions?
I mean, there's some slight differences here. The litigation settlement, according to the amendment, was actually, the bonding authority was increased under this bill to 2.46 million, which I'm assuming was an oversight. And then the same extending period for bonding, but this...
But the liability affecting the village of Herkimer may actually be more than that, which affects the issue of the village ability. Any questions? Can I get a motion to move 6814? Motion by Senator Little, second by Senator Stuart Cousins. All in favor?
Aye.
I-6 needs one, Senator Ball.
And the last bill first this morning is Senate 6867, which I sponsor.
Senate 6867 by Senator Martin's enactment of a property tax law in relation to allowing certain special assessing units other than cities to adjust their current base proportions. Specifically, this bill amends Section 1803A of the real property tax law by adding a new paragraph X in order to authorize special assessing units other than cities in the county of Nassau to adjust their current base proportions by no more than 1% of the immediate preceding year's base proportion.
Villages.
Just for the village?
Just for the, well, it's
anybody, towns can do it too, really, other than a city.
Right, but they don't, the towns in Nassau County do not have assessment units. The assessments are done by the county or by the villages, those are the two with, or the cities with assessing units. Some villages, cities, this in this case is the county.
See, in our area, the village assessment doesn't count for school or county taxes or town taxes.
Right.
So the towns do, or the county does it.
The county handles the assessments in Nassau County for...
That's really just Nassau County and the city of New York that have these base...
Something we're struggling with. Make a motion, move it. Thank you, Senator Ritchie. Second by Senator Stuart Cousins. All in favor?
I-7.
Bill is reported. Madam Senators, thank you very much. It's great to see you. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you.